Eric, back to the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. I just read a great study, very interesting, about Clostridium difficile. So C. diff is a bacteria that we all have, but it can go out of control and just go completely ballistic when, in some people, when they're given antibiotics. This is another main reason why I'm not a fan of just everyone routinely taking antibiotics for sniffs, sniffles and coughs and small cuts and things like that. So I can remember producing a video a few years ago regarding antibiotic usage, particularly in America. Back in the 50s, it was so common that women actually carried antibiotics in their purse. And if anyone had a cough or sniffle, they were immediately given an antibiotic because they were touted as like a cure-all drug that would cure any kind of disease. Well, now we actually know they probably created more disease than they cured these drugs. So just be very, very careful about antibiotic usage. I'm absolutely convinced the day will come in the future when these drugs will never be used again, ever prescribed, and seen as a very, very like dark annal in medical history. I'm talking 100 years from now, not obviously in 5 years, but well into the future, it'll be seen as one of the, you know, like applying leeches to people or cutting people to make them bleed and things like that. It'll go down as that type of treatment by an enlightened society. Not that we are today, unfortunately. So, but this study was very interesting. So what they did, or what this lady found, Lisa Dawson from the London Tropical School of Medicine and Hygiene. It was interesting when I was in India a long time ago, I went to one of the tropical schools there in Calcutta, talked with one of the professors, and that was the school where malaria was first discovered and really expanded on. Malaria is quite a complicated disease. But let's look at C. diff. So many people get C. diff. It can be hospital-borne, but often just by taking antibiotics. So what Dr. Dawson discovered in this study in London was that C. diff actually produce this kind of chemical called paracresol. So this chemical is secreted by C. diff and it smothers and it kills other bacteria around it, but it doesn't harm itself, which is very, very interesting. So when she got hold of some C. diff and made a mutant C. diff that doesn't produce the paracresol and put that into mice, she found that particular strain of C. diff, which lacked the paracresol, had plenty of other bacteria growing around it. But the one that wasn't mutant, the original C. diff in a mouse study, showed that the paracresol smothered and killed lots of bacteria, and just which will obviously allow the C. diff to ramp up production. So C. diff is one of the very few conditions where a fecal transplant has shown to work reasonably well. But I've had many people over the years asking me if FMT, fecal microbial transplant, is any good. And I say it's not worth the 20 grand, you know, but if you've got C. diff, it probably is worth it. So that's my take on it. C. diff, paracresol, and the study. Thanks for tuning in. Click on the link underneath in the description box if you want my free 17-page Candida report. Thank you.